Hi, welcome to this week's episode of The Shtick, where we're here at the bar with Southwick, the good old bar. How many times have we sat?
Henry?
It's the middle of the day, mate. I don't think we want to be drinking.
Fair enough.
Now, you're here because I haven't had you on for so long.
Yeah, in your new place by the bar, great to be back on The Shtick, and I know there's so much to talk about.
I know, we're going to make it short and sweet today because you're a busy man.
Yeah, look, loving the job. Thank you to everybody that re-elected me because I don't think I've been on The Shtick since then. I thought it might be kind of an easing into this year, but it's just been chaotic and lots to do I'm really enjoying it. It's been great.
There's been a lot of controversy as usual, but the biggest one was the leader of the opposition, John Pesutto, who got into a bit of trouble last week.
Well, he didn't get into trouble. It was one of our colleagues, Maury Deeming, who attended a rally, which he shouldn't have. And consequently, we had neo-Nazis turn up, and you saw the salutes on TV, which was just horrific to us, to the broader community, to the trans community. And so we need laws, we need powers and protections, firstly, to ensure that there are consequences for those people that use a salute or use any kind of intimidatory activities, which is what those Nazis did and what they will continue to do. So it's a behavioural thing that we've got to have. It's not just banning the salute, it's a lot more than that. But I know you're alluding to the issues in terms of us looking at
Suspending
what was a suspension for 9 months. Yep. It was initially looking at expelling Moira from the Liberal Party. This is a big move for any party to expel a member. I don't know whether Daniel Andrews, with all of his issues, has expelled anybody. But we don't take this stuff lightly. But John's very, very, as he should be, supportive of the community, of trans, of all people. And we just can't have that kind of behaviour. Now, there were a lot of set of circumstances at the end when it was discussed in the party room. And obviously, I can't go through the details of what happens in the party room. But, you know, Moira did give a very emotional plea and gave information that we didn't know before. She condemned certainly the protest and elements of what was said by the organiser of the protest. She mentioned the fact that she has an uncle that's a Holocaust survivor and she gave a very set of personal circumstances that has been put in the public media about her own abuse as a child, and I'm not going to go into that, but there was a number of those issues that, you know, John and I at the time then looked at one another and said, you know, she needs a second chance
just
to be able to
slap
show
on
her.
The wrist.
Well, it's 9 months, but at the end of the day, her actions from now on will be up to her. And you know, really, we want to see somebody that learns from their mistakes, as we always believe someone should. But at the end of the day, there is no place for hate. You know that I've been a firm believer of that.
Totally.
And whether it be any kind of community, and also no place for those Nazis on the steps of Parliament.
Yeah, well, you've been at the forefront of banning the Nazi symbol ever since the whole issue came up, and it is now banned, I presume.
Yeah, it is banned. And, you know, we'll do whatever we can to support the government ensuring salutes, other imagery, but also behavioural. So you lower the bar so people misbehave and cause incitement of hate. That's when they need consequences.
Yeah. Turning to good news,
Thank God for that. We're at a bar, so we've got to have some good news.
We can drink to that.
Yeah.
Malka Leifer yesterday was found guilty.
Yeah. Yeah, no, this is great news. And I know so many people have played a role in this, and thank you to everybody. And it's a big thing for the girls and the three sisters of what they've gone through. It's been a roller coaster, a jarring roller coaster of ups and downs.
Oh, yeah.
And finally, we've got there. I know that I went to Israel on two occasions, one to present a petition of 17,000 signatures locally to get Leifer extradited back to Melbourne. And then I met with the three sisters, with the Justice Minister, trying to get her back. So there were a couple of instances going to Israel firsthand being part of this. But, you know, like, it is... thankfully, closure for the sisters and survivors of abuse to be able to see this chapter close. I mean, really, someone that through the in darkness escapes to Israel, over 75, 13 years later, 75 different court cases to try and get her back. She's finally back, 2 years of a court case, and now we have her guilty of sexual assault and rape. So it's a fitting closure to what's been a traumatic story.
Certainly has. And in the end, the truth prevails.
The truth and prevails justice. And yep. justice. And yep. we must always put victims and survivors first in our court system, in our justice system.
Correct. Now, the main reason I got you on.
We need a DJ deck here.
You're going to be performing as a DJ at this year's Yom Ha'átzaut Festival. There'll be a party, a festival, yeah. and free rides at Luna Park. It's all going to be centered around the Palais,
yeah.
Luna Park, yeah. and the festival will be in the gardens.
Yeah, it will be. And I haven't played a DJ set for a long while, Henry, so I'm a bit rusty.
Yeah.
And I know a lot of people are giving me requests to play all the favourites. And, you know, one of the things, people remember me back then, or some people haven't actually seen me DJ, think of me back then, mm. I was a great mixer and could beat mix and do all this fantastic stuff that DJs of today do. But my secret of DJing was actually, I was a party starter. I got the people on the dance floor.
Yeah.
And whether it's the YMCA, the bus stop, the Nutbush, the Israeli songs as well. I did all of that to kind of create the vibe and the atmosphere. And so that's what we'll probably look at doing in terms of the big thing on April 26. I'm really, really happy that we've raised now over $10,000 for Ukrainian refugees, which was a plan of this to ensure that we get refugees back to Israel as part of Yom Ha'átzaut and Israel's birthday. So it's for a great cause. I've got between now and the 26th to do some practicing and also take the request and hopefully get the party started on Yom Ha'átzaut.
Well, you'll be on the shtick in the near future again playing the DJ because I'll be there filming the event, of course.
Good. Yeah, great.
So we'll capture some of your music and I'll try and get some dance steps going.
I was going to say, only if you promise to get on the dance floor. We need you leading
the
dancing.
I'll be next to you playing the drums.
Bring the drums. Yeah, great. That would be great. That's what we want to do. Mm. Bring your dancing shoes, everybody. Let's get ready to party because Israel is a great, you know, it's a great celebration of Israel's birthday and we really want people to enjoy that.
Fantastic. Well, we're going out now because we've got a Zoom call coming up with a fellow by the name of Mark. I always find it hard to pronounce some. Friedgut.
Okay, good.
And he's coming down from Sydney. He's a barrister and a constitutional lawyer. He knows a lot about the reform, judicial reform that's going on in Israel. So we're going to get another viewpoint, because last week we did a whole episode on saving Israel's democracy,
yeah.
which are people more on the left. He's a bit of a supporter of the AJA. And so it's been great to have you on. I have one more question, which I love the answer you gave me to. Why haven't you been turning up to the rallies?
Yeah, there's been enough of my colleagues that have attended protests, so I don't think it needs any more of us. But on a serious note, I think it's great that people do get out there and protest. Mm. Israel is so important. Israel's democracy is so important, so I have no issue with that. But as a member of parliament, I think that I also have an obligation in terms of what I do to not be the activist leading the protests, but to be the one that actually is out there and running the argument. I'll be going to Israel in June, July, and I'd be happily to be advocating on behalf of those protesters when I meet with members of the Knesset and certainly taking that plight. Hopefully it'll be sorted by then, but if it's not, I'll certainly be taking some of the feedback and some of the issues over to Israel when I visit with the Leader of the Opposition, John Pesutto, who I'll be taking with me.
It's always a pleasure,
Thank
David.
You. Thank
Thanks
you very
for
much.
Having
pleasure.
The time to come along. And we'll be back
no
after... we love the shtick. We'll be back after the break with our next guest on Zoom from Sydney.